First thing you'll notice on the performance version of this car is that the front fascia is different. And you can see the ducts on the side here where we take the air from the front of the car and really duct it around the wheel. And it's a different splitter across the front too, so that helps with the downforce and the overall lift balance of the car. On the rear of the car, we added a spoiler and we improved the rear diffuser. And it's a carbon fiber splitter. And you can see, like, even the details here where we want downforce in the center of the car, but then we want range and aero efficiency. We have this little notch here. Maybe it's a detail that somebody would think is just a styling cue, but it's actually a performance element to the spoiler. So let's check out the interior. This is where there's a lot of change for the performance version. And I think the first thing you'll notice is the seat.
The new seat is supporting me now. I can really go for the corner and look how the car goes over this ridge. Like, we literally fly through.
It grips you right here in the thighs, in the hip. Really comfortable for everyday driving.
As well, we have these new forged wheels. Not only decrease the mass to keep the overall vehicle mass down, but they also have a little bit more stiffness, which allows for tighter turn and feel.
They also come integrated with these aero caps here. These also work with the unique front and rear fascias that we have on the car to move the air around these larger wheels and tires. And this is where we're balancing vehicle driving and vehicle handling and also the range and efficiency of the car. We've also got an upgraded brake pad to take higher thermal loads and perform better.
We have a new steering knuckle for the performance car that has a slightly shorter steering arm, which decreases the overall steering ratio, making it a little bit quicker. And then we have brand new adaptive damping system, first time ever on a Model 3, with an active valve here that adjusts dynamically when you're driving the car. The tires are co-developed with Pirelli and us to be quieter, more efficient, have higher grip, and better performance laterally. All new drive unit here for the Model 3 Performance. We also have a new inverter here, and we have precision ground gears to increase efficiency, as well as a lower friction oil in there that we call KAF, kick-ass fluid, in order to get all of the performance out of all of this together. Now we're getting new drive units, you're getting new suspension, you're getting adaptive damping, you have new seats in the car that are more supportive for spirited driving. So we were able to do all that while also improving the comfort. So it's really kind of a car that can do both things.